Welcome to Bulldog Underground. This is Miss Joan. Have a great lunch.
Welcome back, guys, to our fifth episode of Bulldog Underground. Obviously, Halloween was this week. How was your guys' Halloween?
Pretty successful, not gonna lie.
It was good. I went to bed at like 7:30, I'm not gonna lie.
You guys get a lot of candy?
No, I mean, for Halloween, I was a cashier. You
know? Yo, we forgot to bring the bowl in of all of our candy.
I don't have any candy. Yeah, I didn't get any candy.
I'll make sure to bring Chris some peanut M&Ms.
Well, bro, trying to kill me. Okay.
Shout out to the peanut.
We don't
want to
do that. So for this week's Bulldog Bite, guys, it is going to be, if you could have one unlimited gift / talent or like superhero power, what would it be, why, and how would you use it?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Who wants to go first? Got a lot of options when you're saying that.
I want to hear Chris's. He's pondering in the corner.
He is.
I was thinking about this, right, guys? I was thinking, like, wouldn't it be kind of cool to, like... Okay, well, first of all, I was thinking, like, a basic one, like, flying or, like, super speed. Like, it sounds cool, like, in reality. But, like, dude, you're going to fly, and then it's like, what? You're not, like, immune to, like, freezing to death. You're going to be, like, 20,000 feet in the air, and you're just going to die because, like, you can't breathe. Or, like, you're moving too fast, and you're breaking the laws of physics. Like, dude, it's just, like, that's just not how it works, right? But I was thinking... What if, like, you had, like all the knowledge in the world? Like, you literally, like, you just knew
like
everything.
Ancient times knowledge
like anything you wanted to know, you would know. But then I would say, like, wouldn't, like, if word got out that, like, you knew everything, bro, you'd be, like, tracked down, like, 17 government agencies.
Imagine how much homework people are going to want you to do.
They would dissect your brains.
I mean, Chris doesn't do his homework.
Okay, why?
Okay, I'm in class with him. Four classes, actually. He... does his work sometimes.
Sometimes.
I feel like he does laps and he wanders.
Sometimes.
I want to check your how many steps you have per day.
Oh, it's a lot. it's a lot.
I caught him doing a puzzle one time in class, too. Ooh. Off topic. I think that my superpower gift thingy, whatever, I would pick walking through walls. Now ask me, guys.
It's not bad. Why would you want that, Janae?
Why do you
want
to walk through walls, Janae?
I would want to... You guys ruined it. I would want to walk
you
through
said
walls.
Ask.
I know, I was just kidding. I was trolling. I want to walk through walls because I feel like, first, no one's going to ever expect you to walk through a wall. Like, imagine just having a nice secret conversation and boom, Janae's walking through the wall. It would be scary, first off. Yeah, but I just think that, first off, you'll be, like, amazing at tag. They'll never catch you.
Yeah, definitely.
And
until you're playing tag with the Flash.
I don't know. I think it's kind of cool. If you get locked in like a room or something, or you get in prison, or not condoning that, but if you get locked up, you can just walk out.
But now, can you walk through any type
of
wall?
Yeah, anything. Any wall,
anything.
Car,
cement, brick,
anything. Plaster. You can go to the mantle if you wanted to.
Can you go like up and down? Can you go like
yeah,
up and
so
down?
Yeah,
like,
why would you be stuck in one spot? I'd be going everywhere.
So there's absolutely nothing in the world that could stop you.
Exactly.
That is that's a pretty legit superpower.
Yeah, you see? You guys, now you're knowing for...
Andrea?
Mine's a little bit more basic, but... Because you guys know I'm very basic, but...
Oh, who would have thought?
Not too much.
I think reading minds would be cool. Uh-oh. Like, you know, like, people who
that
think a
lot...
That
would be cool. But just think about this. What if you, like, aren't good at controlling it, and, like, you just hear everybody's minds...
What if someone, like, sitting right next to you, and, like, for positive reasons, not for negative reasons, because there's plenty of things I can think about, just all types of crazy things. Like, what if someone's, like, next to you, and they're like, oh, I really want to get this, like, nice gift for Andrea, and you hear it? Like, you would never be surprised. Yeah. You see it coming every time.
But, like, if you were
cool,
able
though.
To control, like,
yeah,
what you want to
you could almost, like, make it, like, an on-off switch.
Yeah, like an on and off switch.
Like, I want to listen to what they're talking
about. Or if you think
about.
Someone's, like, mad at you... We can, like, read their minds.
Andrew would be like, is Janae mad at me?
I don't really know what mine would be. Like, I'm kind of leaning towards, like, teleportation.
You look like you would teleport.
And, like, just being able to get anywhere in a matter of seconds.
Yeah. I can honestly see you flying, though. Like, you just give me, like, Superman,
yeah, like,
and I'm going to fly
up and away.
Exactly.
Yeah, but that'd be good. I don't know.
Well, like we already discussed why flying is like bad, because like you fly and it's like then what? Like,
yeah, but you think like Superman flies, you don't think he's like getting frostbite up there?
Okay, well Superman, he's like built different. Like,
but I'm gonna be built different when I'm flying.
Yeah, we're all gonna be built different.
How about like superheroes? Immortality?
Well, you just don't die like ever. Like okay, you don't die or you can't feel pain, because I feel like those are like two different things.
Can't feel pain, but like what if you break your arm? You have no idea you break your arm, and then you end up like with like some crazy disease or something because you broke your arm. You didn't know it was broke.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then I would think about that. Or you're like you have a broken ankle.
But like if I'm teleporting and then I just teleport to like a like place that I don't know, like that could put me in serious harm.
Yeah.
Because. Like right here, I would use my teleportation for just get around. I don't have to worry about cars. Don't got to worry about gas. Don't need to worry about planes, trains.
Like say I wanted nothing. To go to like Hawaii, I can just
like I'm taking a weekend there. Trip to California right now. Bye. Yeah. Boom.
And then like just like in the show, like you grab anyone, you can just take them with you. Just
make any phantom on them. I would use mine to escape school. Coming for attendance
until they look at the cameras and see Janae walk through the wall.
Maybe should have said this like in school, but go for attendance. Guys go to class, but go for attendance and then walk out, go get food or whatever, go get Starbucks with Sir Eddie and come back. And then
they'll never know.
Yeah,
never
and then she could read my mind for when I'm coming back, so she could pack up my things for me. You see? Ooh, and then you could fly over, come join us. I forgot what year it was again.
I think I'm okay.
Chris is the smartest guy in the entire universe.
So he already thought about what we were doing. So then we could all end up going there and then we could just scoop up whatever we want.
I don't know if that's what I want to do, bro. Because, like, dude, you become the smartest and then you're a target. Like, I may be the smartest. I'm not the strongest.
But you're not to play dumb. Like,
if
you don't know anything.
If all of China wants me dead, bro, I'm just going to die. China. Like, there's nothing I can do. I was thinking, what if, like, I was. The best at anything I wanted to. Like, anything I, like, tried to be the best at. Like, if I wanted to be the best, like, professional, like, tennis player. Like, I could just pick it up and, dude, I'd be,
boom.
Like, that'd be crazy. Like, wouldn't that be so cool? Like, the best at anything I tried.
Yeah. Just, like, automatically good at everything.
So, now I have to ask, does this go for, like, because you're the smartest person ever, does it mean you can work anything? Like, any car, anything. Like, anything that just you would have to think about or someone would have knowledge on, like, you already know how to work it. Like, you go walk into somewhere and just know, like, how to work a machine because you're so smart and, like, you already thought of it.
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay. But, like, got Chris thinking over here.
how do you know everything? Are you, like, looking at it for the first time and being like, you know, boom, 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 got
Such
it, and now you know how it, and now
like
you know how to do
veins.
It all?
No, dude, just, like, I look
or
at
Or, like,
I look
from
at
the it. Moment you existed, you knew it all.
No, dude, like, I look at something, and I just, like, know, like,
it
I
just
know
just clicks
what's going on.
It goes right in your mind.
Yeah, I know what to do.
He's knowing for real.
I'm just locked in.
Are you guys big on, like, superhero Marvel movies and stuff like that at all?
I definitely think Marvel is better than DC.
Because, like, I be watching a lot of Marvels, and now when I heard of this bite, I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
What are some of these superhero powers that I'd be seeing?
Yeah.
Like Thor, who's got a hammer
that only he can
pick up?
Even
that's dope.
Captain America. Yeah. Like,
or
he
Iron
really
Man.
Had powers like that. He just had his little shield.
Yeah. But he was just like...
Yeah,
yeah.
It was like super soldier.
Who else? Like,
I'm not really
like,
big on Marvel.
That would be so cool to me if I had something that was only usable to me.
Yeah,
like you go to try to pick that up and boom, it's not going anywhere.
Yeah. But who was able? I think
it was Captain America.
Yeah,
in the end.
Yeah, he was able to pick up.
He
his
He was worthy enough. Yes, he was.
I think I'll be worthy enough.
That'd be crazy to me. Like, I'd wanna be able to like make these superpowers and like boom.
Imagine someone else tries using it and it just, like, doesn't work. But there's a book that you, like, touch, Chris, and then, like, it, like, feeds into you. But, like, someone else touches it and it's, like,
What if somebody took all of these powers we just said but used them for bad? Like,
Ooh.
Chris, smartest man in the world. He knows how to make any weapon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Janae,
you can walk
through walls. So, boom, you get arrested. Bye-bye.
You're gone.
Oh, Andrea, who, what'd you say you were doing? You're basic reading minds. Like... You might not be the smartest, but you get in the room with somebody, you know everything now. Me? I mean, I could teleport into, like, a volcano or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, who knows if I teleport in the wrong spot? It's like, that's crazy.
ooh, like some like a jam, and then you end up in like the middle of the Red Sea. Yeah, like, or something.
I have to think about it as I'm, you know, changing my location. Yeah. But say mid thought, I'm like, oh, I want sushi.
Yeah, I was gonna
and
ask.
And then boom, I'm just in a sushi shop now.
Measure inside the sushi roll.
Yeah.
Like that'd be terrible.
That would be pretty funny though. Not gonna lie.
Like you just had like no control at all, and then like all of a sudden I go to walk through like a wall. I think I'm walking outside to like the field or something. And I end up walking into like someone's random house or something like that. It's crazy.
Yeah, just like those superpowers can be good or bad.
Low key, thinking about it, I'd want to have powers like Spider-Man.
Yeah,
like the spider powers, because walks on buildings, like that's sick. He's flexible, can fight crazy, and he's got webs that he's shooting from, like pew pew pew.
Yeah, if I had to choose someone to like copy, I think it would be Captain America. You know, like he's still, at the end of the day, like he still was able to like grow old, have a life, like he was, you know. Or Doctor Strange though. I'm gonna stick with my boy Doctor Strange, Dr. Stephen Strange.
Going crazy. Guy.
Maybe I would choose like.
We just got our own Avengers down here, pretty much. Like, okay, the Avengers crew underground.
And I get one of the stones too before Thanos takes it.
All right, well, Chris, final powers, what is it?
I'm going back to knowing everything. Knowing everything, dude. That'd be pretty cool.
So, Mr. Big Brain?
Mr. Big Brain.
Janae?
I'm going to stick with walking through walls and stuff.
All right.
Hopefully, Janae doesn't come in my house one time.
Walk into Angel's room.
Yeah, right?
In the Little Einstein's theme song or something.
Yeah. But, like, what would you use that for? Like, I know you can use it just, like, go places, but, like...
I would use it to get out of situations that I don't want to be in.
Like what? Like, awkward conversation? Just shimmy your way out the back door?
Or like lines, just walk out or something. Yeah. I mean, I wasn't using it to steal or anything. That's terrible. But, you know, don't want to wait in line or tired of just waiting. Because I'm impatient. I'm very impatient. So that makes sense.
Yeah. Andrew?
I'll stick with reading minds. I think that would be... very useful.
I think that one could be very good.
Yeah. Very useful, yeah.
But what would have you put all our powers together? So you're smart, you could read minds, you could teleport. Leave anywhere, and you could fly. Wait, what did you just fly?
Teleport? No, teleport.
Teleport and walk through walls.
Mm-hmm. No, yeah, literally. Imagine.
You're literally
superhuman.
Yeah, you're him, bro.
You're him. Like, change your pronouns, because he's him. How about you? Oh, wait, you said
teleport. Yeah. So, I think that'd be sick powers if we were all able to get them one day.
Yeah. Yep.
I think it should come true.
We can only dream.
Oh.
We have to find like some magical tree in the forest or something.
Make our wishes the next day.
Exactly. Boom.
Today, in the doghouse with, we are thrilled to introduce the mayor of Stratford, the Honorable Mayor Laura Hoydick. We are all super excited to have you on. Thank you so much for coming down here.
Well, it's my pleasure to be here.
We're super excited. Well, I'm reading the text.
Yeah.
It was like, here are your schedules. I was like, okay.
We had the idea and we weren't sure if we were actually going to be able to pull it through. So, very excited to have
you here. We're excited you're here.
Oh, thanks. Me too. Well, you had your Secret Service working on it and they were successful. So.
Yeah.
He does a good job.
Would you mind telling us how you got into politics and how you started with all that?
Sure. So, I know it sounds like really, but I got involved politically because I was a volunteer. Still am a volunteer, but I volunteered in PTAs and I volunteered a lot at Sterling House and liked working with people and improving their lives in general. And so when I was a mom at Second Hill Lane, my husband and I got very involved in the PTAs and then realized that, you know, if you want to affect more positive change, you need to do that through policy and process and procedure. And the way to do that for schools and kids and staff was to get on the Board of Ed. And so that was, I ran for the Board of Ed in 97 and won.
It's very nice.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So election day is coming up, also my birthday, so super excited for that. Can you tell us, can you tell our listeners why it's so important to go out and vote?
Because those that are setting policy, process, and procedure are the result of people who vote. And ballots cast for them.
Yeah.
And if you don't like the agenda that someone has or the campaign that they're running, then you want to make sure you go and you vote for the person that you do want. Yeah. And often you'll see, especially we've seen it a lot in Connecticut, it happens in Stratford, that the vote count is so close that they have to recount again. And they do that a lot in Bridgeport. We've done it again in Stratford. It's most, a lot of municipalities do that because people vote or don't vote enough, and so there's not an overwhelming majority on who they're selected or electing.
Exactly. You'd think a lot of people would want to vote, especially with all the people that talk about wanting change. You know, you'd think that they would be eager like to kind of get in there and make that change happen.
Right, but, don't complain about a problem, then don't vote. I mean.
But think about it. If you are intimidated to cast a ballot because you don't think you know enough, that puts a lot of people off. I don't know who's running. I don't know what they stand for. It's hard to do the research. It's been easier lately, but that used to be a common theme. And so people don't have to be perfect to cast their ballot. I mean, you get the right to vote once you register, and you get to pick. It's your choice, and that's your choice.
You're good. I understand that there's a question on the ballot regarding early voting. Could you just explain that and what that is to us really quick?
Sure. So the question is, shall there be early voting in Connecticut? Which seems like a pretty straightforward question. What we don't know is how will early voting be implemented? Because if this should pass, then the General Assembly in Hartford is going to make the decisions on how it will be implemented.
Okay.
So this question has come up in different reiterations. Two ballot questions have happened recently, and they both haven't passed because there's been no finite answer about how early voting will be implemented. Yeah. So it's just something we should be aware of and do your research, I guess, and find out if you support it. And if you do, then you vote for it.
How early would early voting start?
That's all the part that's that we don't know. That's all still up in the air. That's right. That is exactly. And the other thing is, say you vote. We talked about this a little bit, but say you vote and something came out about one of the candidates that you happen to vote for and you want to not vote. Are you going to be able to go and get your ballot back? So those are the questions that I would think about before I voted for or against early voting.
All right. Well, make sure to then look at those questions and think about it if you're going to be voting for it.
So as we have learned, the political office can be a long and stressful process. In your opinion, what is the most challenging part about the political race every year?
About the election process? Yeah. It's really hard when your opponents are saying things about you that aren't true or you don't believe are true and trying to get that message out to the public that are voting for you. You'll see it a lot right now in the gubernatorial debate and the Senate. There's a lot of negative ads all over the place because the race is so tight. Mm-hmm. And Congress is close to tied, that they're putting a lot of money into this because they obviously are, the political parties are advertising for their side. So last year, when I ran for mayor and there were significant negative campaigns, it kind of makes you feel bad, first of all, because, you know, it wasn't true.
Who wants to see stuff like that out in the world?
It was the distressed municipality thing that was being purported as my fault. So you have to educate the public about that whole process. But it almost is, if the negative ads are coming out, then you know the race is tight.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It didn't end up being that way for me last year, but I bet you this year, as we're watching these campaigns go on election on your birthday, Janae, we'll see. I bet you it's going to be closer than we think it is.
Yeah, I see a lot of ads all the time. Yeah. Like I'll be heard one this morning. I'll be on like YouTube or like something that has ads on it, and I'll get like two ads in a row that are like completely different, but they're like about the same person.
I was watching my Hulu and I seen one the other day, and I was like, I'm just trying to watch the Modern Family.
I see all the commercials at 11 o'clock when I'm watching the news. Yeah. All the commercials to vote and stuff.
It's 11 o'clock at night, trying to relax. When it's going
really quick, because we're kind of talking about, you know, what is stressful. Do you get an off day? Do you get off days at all? Or is this like a 24/7, 365 type thing?
It's 24/7, 365.
Mental health days? I would cry.
So, like, what if you're sick? Do you get to call in sick? Is that like a...
Yeah, but I do, but like during COVID, I was in the office.
Oh.
And you're still the mayor, you're still in charge. So there are provisions in the charter if I was unable to serve or perform, then somebody would step in. But that would only be in a terrible situation. Yeah. Thank God.
Yeah.
But
yeah, that would be way too stressful every day. Not having weekends, holidays.
Like, do you like that? Like just constantly being busy?
I was just going to say, but I love it. Yeah. So the advocacy piece started from when I was a kid. My family, I grew up, that's just how you are. You know, you give back to your community and you end up feeling really good about yourself because you're making somebody else's life better.
Definitely.
So, but it does get tiring because you need a break for your mental well-being, right?
Yeah.
We learned that. If we didn't learn that with COVID, then, I mean, there's a lot of things we should have learned. But, you know, you have to take care of yourself in order to take care of somebody else.
Yeah.
And when you guys become parents, don't forget that. It's really important to take care of yourself because if you don't, mentally and physically, financially, all this around, you're not going to be able to take care of the ones who are depending on you.
Yeah.
Last mom preaching.
No more. Since you've been in office since 2017, what have been some of your biggest accomplishments that you've had?
So I'm going to say it's not just me. It's the town council, too, because they're the legislative body. They set the laws and approve the budgets and all these kind of things. But together, we brought civility back to public office because council previous to them, it was very dramatic and very emotional, and not that many good policies happened. The budget wasn't passed, and there were significant things that really made it difficult to operate the town. So through this council, we were able to stabilize things, have professional courtesy with each other, treat each other well. Even when you disagree, you can have civil discourse. There's a way to go about it or not. We lowered the mill rate 4 years in a row, so that was really good. So what that means is our taxes, our property taxes went down just a little bit, but it's still, we were able to maintain and deliver the same services. So I'm really, really proud about that. I'm proud how we all managed COVID because we worked not just on the municipal side, on the school side too, the superintendent, Dr. Robinson, the health director, Andrea Bosevan, and I had a press conference right after the case was revealed about the Wilcoxon school student.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we pulled together like we never have before. Your school health nurse, Kim Velasquez, worked with our health department and Andrea. And it was hard because we didn't know where we were going or how this was all going to evolve. But we really pulled it together to work together.
That's good.
Yeah,
That's what you need when something like that happens, especially when COVID came around. You needed everybody to pull together.
That was crazy.
Wasn't time for you all to be singled out.
Right.
Yeah.
And then we did some really cool things like the Stratford High renovation. Your field, I mean,
Your beautiful.
Field looks like a college campus.
It is.
We were just talking
beautiful.
About that, especially like with all like the leaves and everything. I was like, it looks really nice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we've been slowly. Steadily improving Stratford, trying to make it a better place to live.
Yeah, that's great. Definitely. Thank you.
So without showing all your cards, we were wondering if you have your sights set on any other political office, like if you want to be in any other political office in the future.
I do not.
You don't?
Other than politics, what's something that you find interesting? Got any hobbies?
Yeah, I have several hobbies. I don't get to do them as much now, but you know, I came up through the Stratford school system, played 5 instruments, was involved in the band and the chorus. I ride horses. I played sports. Now I'm playing golf, but before I played softball, volleyball, those kind of things. And but I really love making people's lives better because it's so fulfilling.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do that for somebody, even, you know, your own friends in school, if you see somebody struggling, you can make it easier for them. Doesn't that make you feel good?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so that's a real positive part about being mayor for me.
I love that you have 7 hobbies. I could barely find one besides sleeping.
Well, you're also, what, 16?
Yeah.
But that's amazing how you're so into giving back to the community.
That's how my family was.
That's great.
Important. Yeah.
I know that's how, like, when I was coming through chapel, I know my parents were always involved in, you know, my school. And I hope, like, you know, when I become a father, I can be involved and get involved with my town and community.
Good. Yeah. And your parents are probably still doing stuff.
Yeah.
If it's not just in school anymore, they're going to give back some other way.
Yeah, they are.
That's great.
Well, Mayor Hoydick, we speak on behalf of the entire Bunnell community when we say it was a real pleasure getting to speak with you today. We learned an awful lot, and we're thankful for you and for all that you do for our town. Good luck with your races, and we hope everything comes out good on Tuesday. And we just want to thank you so much for finding time out of your busy schedule to come be with us today.
It's really an honor for you guys to invite me. I'm really thrilled.
Thank you so much.
And I'll see you, is it next week? Is the Veterans Lunch something?
I think
next week. So I'll be back at Bunnell.
Okay.
You can't get rid of me that much.
We'll see you then.
Okay. Take care.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And now it's time for Dog Tracks. I'm going to start this segment off with my song I've listened to the past week. 31 Days by Future. She want me to leave. She know I'm not a red, I got cheese. I cried in the mouth. When I got in her mouth, she couldn't breathe. I was thinking like, geez, she done got a little slow. It's a classic, good song.
All right. Next. Chris, what you got?
You know, it's a little bit of a throwback for all my old ones out there. 8 Days a Week by the Beatles. Ooh, I need your love, babe. Guess
you know. That's a good song.
It's another good one.
I think I gotta go with Baby Keem, Highway 95 this week. Baby cook some, took the 95 to the 110, headed your way,
through the pipe and Drake, through the yellow tape, through the motor. Also known as Boom Bap and Rap.
It's just been giving me the good vibes.
I'm gonna go with Call Out My Name by The Weeknd. So call out my name. I love The Weeknd. It's been a really good song.
It's a banger, so still is.
The whole album's just great.
Yeah.
All right, what's your favorite song, Mr. Koch?
Well, Julian took mine this week. That's the one I was going to go with. So instead, I think I'm going to go with No Sleep Till Brooklyn by the Beastie Boys, old school classic. Check it out. It's good stuff. No Sleep Till Brooklyn.
All right, you guys heard it here. Check those 5 songs out.
And now for our final segment, Running with the Dog. You know, we don't got that much on the agenda for this week. Fall sports are coming to an end.
Winter sports picking up, though.
Uh-huh.
Yep, they're starting soon.
On that topic, we have wrestling conditioning, which has been going on for a while now. Every Tuesday and every Friday, 2:15 at the Bunnell track. You know, show up if you want to get some extra work in before the season, and then basketball conditioning is going on as well.
Yep, girls basketball every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, 6 to 7:30 in the main gym.
Uh-huh.
Come if you want to work sweat on your skills, get better.
Sweat and lift and all that.
Yep.
And then, Andrea, you want to talk about Powder Puff?
Yes, Powder Puff is right around the corner. We have our game against Stratford High, November 17th. It's on a Thursday, 6 o'clock.
What's
here
the theme?
At Bunnell.
Theme is TBA.
To
not
be
there
determined.
Yet.
Oh, okay.
We are still figuring that out, but we will let you know when we got it.
Okay.
And speaking of theme, what's the theme for this week's football game, Julian?
This Friday, we got neon.
Ooh.
Neon this Friday.
Nice.
November 4th, 7 o'clock at Bunnell High School. It's going to be a big game. We won last week. Good game. Another great game this week. Let's
Who's
go.
Against?
New Milford.
New Milford.
I got a wig.
Oh,
perfect.
Hopefully it comes in time.
What color is it? Oh, wait, don't spoil it. We'll see. We'll see you on the Bunnell page.
It's good. Need to see you all in neon. As many supporters as possible. Let's pack the dog pound. Definitely.
We're tailgating again, right?
Yes, we are. Okay. We're going to get some pizzas, Big Y party pizzas. So be there 5:15, 5:30 before the game. Have something to eat, and then we'll all head down to the field.
Sounds good. Sweet.
Sounds great. Yeah. Well, guys. Oh. Thank you. You could go.
No.
All right, well, thank you guys so much for listening to this episode. It was an amazing episode having the mayor in with us.
Very cool experience.
Yeah,
it was,
definitely.
It was good to know her, like, on a, not a, oh, I've seen her on the news, like, actually meeting her. She's
actually
very nice.
Actually getting to talk
very
to her nice. And have her sit right with us. It was great.
It was.
So thank you guys, and we'll see you next episode.
Bye. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye. Peace. Bulldog Underground is an original Frank Scott Bunnell production, and all thoughts and opinions are expressly those of the participants. The title theme, Beneath the Pipes, was arranged and recorded by G. James Miller at Frank Scott Bunnell High School. This episode was produced by Christopher Buckner and may not be copied or duplicated without authorized consent.